Good morning, class 11th. Welcome to the English session once again. And today, as I had told you, we will be picking up this poem, The Voice of the Rain. Now, written by Walt Whitman. It's a beautiful poetry, very simple, very easy to understand, and written in such an interesting way by this American poet, Walt Whitman. And the entire poem, as you will see here, okay, is in a dialogue form. And as you know that a dialogue takes place between two people. It is never between one person. Had it just been one person speaking, it becomes a monologue. But when there are two people speaking, it is a dialogue. So here, the poem is nothing but a dialogue between two people apparently. One who happens to be the poet, Walt Whitman, and the second that happens to be the rain. And the rain over here has been personified. That is why the title becomes The Voice of the Rain. Now, what is personification? You already must have learnt it in class 10. I will still revise it with you. Personification is when you attach a human quality, a quality of a living person with a non-living thing. Now, a rain is a non-living thing. A rain cannot speak. A rain cannot interact. But here, Walt Whitman personifies rain and gives it a voice. So the moment the rain is personified like a human being, it apparently has a voice. And then there is a dialogue between rain and the poet Walt Whitman. And in this entire poetry, you will see that Whitman highlights very beautifully through the rain. When the rain speaks for itself, it talks about its eternal, you know, life cycle, the life cycle of rain, the water cycle as we call it. And you must have not forgotten that what is the water cycle, or what is the water cycle for the rain. So the water first evaporates from the collected areas on the land. It could be the rivers, lake, seas, ocean, the groundwater. First, what will happen? The water will be evaporating. So the first step in the water cycle is evaporation. After evaporation, the water goes up and then it condenses to become clouds. After condensation, it comes back down again on earth in the form of precipitation. And this is an ever going, ongoing cycle, the water cycle, and there is no end to it. So it is like, you know, it is eternal. It's never going to die. So here you see there is a conversation between rain and the poet Walt Whitman. So, you know, the poetry begins with a question, as you will see. And thereafter, the moment Walt Whitman questions someone, who apparently is the rain over here, he is so shocked and surprised because that someone answer backs the poet. And that someone over here is nobody else but the rain that has been given the voice by Walt Whitman as if it were a human. So let's not waste time and understand this beautiful poem, The Voice of the Rain. So here is the question, and see how does it begin. It begins with "and." So Walt Whitman, the poet, has a question. He asks, "And who art thou?" Art means are. Thou means you. So the poet Walt Whitman asks a question. "And who are you?" said I to the soft falling shower, or to the soft falling shower. So Walt Whitman, who is the poet, this I over here refers to the poet, and the poet is Walt Whitman. So Walt Whitman puts up a question and he says, "Who are you?" And to whom is he putting this question? To the soft falling shower, that is the rain. It's like drizzle. Jab halki halki bilkul barish hoti hai, kitna soft falling shower hota hai. And see, look at this figure of speech used over here. It is imagery. Imagery is when a writer or a poet gives you such vivid details that you can imagine. तो यहाँ soft falling shower से हम imagine कर सकते हैं that this is not a heavy rain. It's a soft falling shower, so apparently it is a drizzle. So Whitman is asking the rain that who are you? Which, strange to tell, gave me an answer as here translated. And in the second line Whitman says, and which is very, very strange to tell. Whitman says it is so surprising that when I asked this soft falling shower that who are you, this soft falling shower gave me an answer. And that answer has been translated here for us by Whitman. I hope I am clear. Now we come to this second I, and this second I is the rain, which has been personified, okay, as a human being. So here the rain answers this question put up by Walt Whitman. I am the poem of earth, said the voice of the rain. जवाब दिया रेन ने, क्या कहा? I am the poem of earth, said the voice of the rain. तो जब विटमैन ने पूछा कि who are you, तो रेन ने बोला I am the poem of the earth. Now see, here Whitman has compared rain to poetry. Poetry और रेन का comparison किया है यहाँ पे, but like or as use नहीं किया है. That is why it is metaphor. Rain has been compared to poetry. तो rain says, I am the poetry of earth. It is so beautiful. See, poetry is so beautiful in itself. It is nothing but so much of expression in terms of love and so many other emotions. So rain says, I am the poem of earth. और यहाँ पे वो clear करता है, said the voice of the rain. And from here onwards, rain starts giving us the entire process of its origin, right from the water bodies till the time when it again comes back to the earth. And this entire process is an eternal process. It's an ongoing process. There is no end to it. So it says, eternal I rise. Eternal मतलब forever, there is no end to it. I कौन है यहाँ पे? Rain. Eternal I rise, impalpable. Impalpable, something that cannot be touched. Eternal I rise से मतलब यहाँ पे क्या हो रहा है? It is referring to its process of evaporation. Out of the land and the bottomless sea. देखो evaporation हो रहा, she is saying, the rain is saying that I rise eternally and I am impalpable, I cannot be touched, vapors cannot be touched children. पानी में से vapor निकलता है, water vapor निकलता है and it is evaporation, you cannot touch it, that is why it is impalpable. So it says, the rain says, I rise eternally out of the land and the bottomless sea. So here the rain explains the first step in its life cycle, that is evaporation. अब evaporation तो हो गया, फिर ये vapors कहाँ जाते हैं? Upward to heaven, obviously towards the sky. सारा vapor, सारा evaporation होके सारा vapor कहाँ जाता है? Towards the sky. Upward to heaven. Whence means where vaguely formed मतलब there is no definite shape. तो जब आसमान में ये सारा वेपर चला गया तो वहां पे सेकेंड स्टेप क्या होगा? कंडेंसेशन. और कंडेंसेशन होके क्या होता है? क्लाउड्स आर फॉर्म्ड. एंड डू क्लाउड्स हैव अ प्रॉपर शेप? नो, क्लाउड्स डू नॉट हैव अ प्रॉपर शेप, दे आर वेग, दे आर इरेग्युलर. सो अपवर्ड टू हेवन where vaguely formed, altogether changed and yet the same. Please understand, it says I go to heaven, I go in the form of vapors. Here my vapors, they take a shape, they take a form, and that is very, very irregular. And it says I am altogether changed. From vapors I take the shape of clouds, but I am still the same. See, From water the vapors have gone, but then again the vapors have changed into clouds. और clouds में से eventually क्या निकलेगा? पानी ही निकलेगा. So even though when the rain says I have changed, it is still the same because clouds have nothing but water. So here it rises as vapor and evaporation takes place, and when it goes to the heaven, when it goes to the skies up above, what takes place? Condensation takes place. Here. Okay? और कंडेंसेशन के बाद क्या होता है बेटा? प्रेसिपिटेशन टेक्स प्लेस, एंड प्रेसिपिटेशन इज नथिंग बट रेन. और फिर वो क्या बोलती है? थर्ड टाइम इट सेज आई डिसेंड, इट सेज देन आई कम डाउन, मैं नीचे आती हूं, बारिश नीचे आती है. और उसके बाद द रेन सेज ऑल द गुड थिंग्स दैट इट डज. आई डिसेंड, आई कम डाउन. कम डाउन वेयर? आई कम डाउन ऑन अर्थ. आई कम डाउन बैक टू माई बर्थ प्लेस. बर्थ प्लेस तो अर्थ ही हुआ है ना, जहां से सब कुछ शुरू हुआ है. आई डिसेंट एज इन आई कम डाउन. आई कम डाउन टू माई बर्थ प्लेस दैट इज अर्थ टू लेव द ड्राउट्स. लेव मतलब वॉश, क्लीन. बारिश आने से क्या क्या होता है? सारा सूखा खत्म हो जाता है, सब कुछ धुल जाता है, साफ, नीट एंड क्लीन. इट इज सो ब्यूटिफुल. द अर्थ गेट्स वॉटर, एवरीथिंग इज क्लीन्ड, एनिमल, बर्ड्स, नेचर, एवरीबडी इज हैप्पी. सो सी, वॉट डज द रेन डू? इट इज टेलिंग अस इट्स जॉब. वेन इट कम्स डाउन ऑन अर्थ, इट लेव्स द ड्राउट्स, इट फिनिशेज द ड्राउट्स. सूखा खत्म. इट वॉशेज द ड्राउट्स, इट वॉशेज द एटमीज, ऑल काइंड ऑफ पार्टिकल्स, डस्ट लेयर्स ऑफ द ग्लोब. सारा धूल, सारा गंदगी, एवरीथिंग दैट इज कवरिंग द प्लैनेट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ डस्ट इज क्लीन्ड अप बाय द वॉटर दैट कम्स विद द रेन. एंड ऑल दैट इन देम विदाउट मी वर सीड्स ओनली लेटेंट अनबॉर्न. एंड सी, जितने भी बीज जमीन में पड़े हुए हैं, जब तक उन पे पानी ना पड़े, जब तक उन पे बारिश ना गिरे, दे आर गोइंग टू बी अनबॉर्न. एंड ऑल दैट इन देम मतलब ऑल दैट इन अर्थ, इन द प्लैनेट, विदाउट द वॉटर वुड ओनली रिमेन सीड्स. रेन सेज दैट आई जस्ट डोंट कम टू वॉश ड्राउट्स एंड डस्ट एंड एटमीज, बट आई ऑल्सो गिव लाइफ. If I do not fall, then these seeds on this planet, on the surface, they are not going to be born. They would be latent, unborn. वो छुपे ही रह जाएंगे. These meanings are given here, all these meanings. So it says they are going to be hidden. भाई ऐसा क्यों होता है? जब इतनी बारिश हो चुकी है तो हर तरफ इतनी घास उग जाती है, इतना ज्यादा पेड़ पौधा उग जाता है. Why? Because there were seeds in the soil, and the moment the soil got water, the moment the rain descended, kya hua? Sare seeds jo hai germinate kar gaye, and there is life. So rain is responsible for leaving the droughts, atomies, dust layers, and also giving life to these seeds, which would have not been possible if it would have not fallen. These seeds would have not germinated. They would have remained hidden. They would have been unborn if the rain would have not fallen. Is it clear, children? Now pay attention. And forever, by day and night, I give back life to my own origin. Aur dekho, ye line, in this line, the rain is saying that this process of water cycle, it is forever, by day and night. I give back life to my own origin. Rain ka origin kya hai? Earth. And earth happens to be the birthplace of rain. Barish se hi to pani earth pe collect ho raha hai. In oceans, rivers, lakes, lakes, water bodies, the ground. यही पानी इवेपोरेट होके ऊपर जाता है, फिर यही पानी वापस आ जाता है. यही पानी ऊपर जाता है, यही पानी वापस आता है. सो दिस इज अ नेवर एंडिंग साइकिल, एंड इट गोज बाय डे एंड नाइट. इट इज गोइंग 24/7. And what is the origin of rain? The origin of rain is earth, which is its birthplace. So it is a complete 24/7 cycle of the birth of rain. And make pure and beautify it. And it says, what does it do? It makes it pure and it beautifies it. It kya hai? The birthplace. Earth. By preparing a life cycle. Agar ye life cycle rain ki na ho, so earth would not remain pure and beautiful. It is pure because it is all nice and clean and washed. It is beautiful because if there is no rain, there would be no greenery, there would be no life, everything would be latent and unborn. To ye kaam hai rain ka. And now please pay attention, the last two lines of the poem, the poet puts them in a bracket. Aur ispe question bhi aata hai ki poet ne ye last two lines bracket mein kyu likhi hain. So first of all, lines samajhte hain, phir is question ko answer karenge. Now the poet in the last two lines, ye to pura answer tha kiska, rain ka, to the question that the poet asked, who are you? To rain ne apne bare mein puri details di yahan tak. Aur phir end mein poet rain ko compare kar raha hai with a song. Again, without using like and as, so it becomes a metaphor. यहाँ पे poet ने rain को किससे compare करा था? Poem से, तो it became metaphor here. यहाँ second time the rain is being compared with a song. Please pay attention. For song, issuing from its birthplace, after fulfillment, wandering, wrecked or unwrecked, duly with love returns. Poet compares the rain with a song. अब सॉन्ग का क्या होता है? अ सॉन्ग इश्यूज फ्रॉम इट्स बर्थ प्लेस. वॉट इज द बर्थ प्लेस ऑफ एनी सॉन्ग? द हार्ट ऑफ अ सिंगर. अ सिंगर इज गोइंग टू सिंग अ सॉन्ग. इट विल बी रिकॉर्डेड, इट विल बी पुट इन टू अ कैसेट, सीडी, वट एवर. एंड देन दिस सॉन्ग इज गोइंग टू ट्रेवल ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड. ओके, इट इज गोइंग टू, द सॉन्ग इज नॉट जस्ट गोइंग टू बी ऑफ अ वन पर्टिकुलर प्लेस, इट इज गोइंग टू ट्रेवल ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड. एंड यू पीपल वुड नो इट वेरी वेल. नाउ इन दिस एज ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, आर वी ओनली सिंगिंग टू आर इंडियन म्यूजिक? नो, यू हैव एक्सेस टू इंटरनेशनल म्यूजिक एज वेल, यू हैव एक्सेस टू ट्रेडिशनल म्यूजिक एज वेल. सो यू आर लिसनिंग टू इंडियन म्यूजिक, लैटिन म्यूजिक, इंग्लिश म्यूजिक, अमेरिकन म्यूजिक, ऑल काइंड ऑफ म्यूजिक. तो poems, the poet says that just like, जैसे एक song निकलता है from the heart of a singer after fulfilling it duty of wandering, it goes all over the world. For example, एक गाना बना India में, then it travels all over the world. It went to US, UK, Australia, Canada, Africa, everywhere. Wrecked or unwrecked, wrecked or unwrecked का मतलब यहाँ पे whether it is loved or not loved, liked or not liked by the people all over the world. अब ये तो option हुआ ना, आपको वो गाना पसंद आया ना, ये आपका choice है. Duly with love returns. Whatever happens to the song, it will come back to its singer, to its origin with love. Duly with love, it is going to return. So just like the song is the rain. The rain is issued from its birthplace, that is earth. Then it does the wandering. It is evaporated, it is condensed, and you know, it falls on all over the planet. Puri duniya mein barish hoti hai. Uske baad wo barish kisi ko pasand aaye ya na pasand aaye. For some people, that rain can be a problem if it gives you floods. Okay? For some people, rain can be a big nonsense if you do not have your own proper arrangements to stay protected from it. So whether you like what the rain is doing or you do not like what the rain is doing, rain will duly with love return to its birthplace. Aur rain ka birthplace kya hai? Earth. So it becomes very, very easy to understand, my dear children, that you know, you will have to draw this water cycle. So here you have earth, here the evaporation takes place, okay, देन व्हाट हैपन, कंडेंसेशन, फिर बारिश होती है, प्रेसिपिटेशन, और वापस पानी कहाँ जाता है, अर्थ पे, फिर एवेपोरेशन, फिर कंडेंसेशन, फिर बारिश. इट्स अ नॉन स्टॉप साइकिल. सो इट ओरिजिन्स, यू नो, इट इश्यूज, रेन इश्यूज फ्रॉम द बर्थ प्लेस, गोज ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड. And whether people like it or they do not like it, they appreciate it or they not appreciate it, it comes back to its actual place of origin. And in case of the rain, it is earth. And in case of the song, it is the heart of a singer. आपको वो गाना पसंद आए या ना पसंद आए, वो गाना सारे में travel करके वापस आ जाता है to the singer because it belongs to the singer. A very, very simple poem, no complications at all, very easy to understand. So here, one thing I would like to highlight, that the first I, only the first I is the I of the poet. Uske baad jo ye I hain, ye sab rain ke I hain. It is the rain talking. Okay? So, it's like 1, 2, 3, 4. Four times the this I has been repeated, and this I refers to the rain, and rain is talking, and because rain is talking, the name of the poetry is The Voice of the Rain. Poet ne ek question kara, and to the surprise of the poet, very strange, poet ko umeed nahi thi ki rain jawab degi. Obviously now this is how Whitman had planned the poetry. So the rain answered back and it said, I am the poem of earth. And then it gives you all the details of evaporation, condensation and precipitation. जब descend हो गई मतलब rain नीचे आ गई, तो मतलब क्या हो गया, precipitation हो गया, और उसके बाद कितना कुछ rain ने करा. These are the things that it does. It gives life to seeds, and these seeds would have been unborn if the rain would have not fallen. So it's a continuous 24/7 thing that is taking place here on the planet. Evaporation, condensation, precipitation, ये cycle पूरा चलता रहता है. And और अब to the question that I had said, और ये book में भी है पीछे, कि why does the poet put these two lines in the bracket? So the poet puts these two lines in the bracket because these are the observations of the poet and his thoughts. ये conversation का हिस्सा नहीं है. कॉन्वर्सेशन तो पोएट और रेन के बीच में यहां तक होके खत्म हो गया. ये ऑब्जर्वेशन और थॉट्स हैं पोएट के, वेर इन ही हैज मेड अ सिमिलैरिटी बिटवीन रेन एंड म्यूजिक. सो दीज आर जस्ट ऑब्जर्वेशन एंड थॉट्स ऑफ द पोएट, वेर द पोएट कंपेयर्स रेन विद म्यूजिक, एंड बिकॉज दीज ऑब्जर्वेशन एंड थॉट्स आर नॉट पार्ट ऑफ द कॉन्वर्सेशन, दैट इज वाई दे हैव बीन पुट इन ब्रैकेट्स. Okay, my dear students, so this is what the whole poetry is about, The Voice of the Rain. I turn the page and we will be doing this NCERT questions in the register. So the first question is, there are two voices in the poem. Who do they belong to? Two voices kiski hai? It's a dialogue. Ek voice hai Walt Whitman ki aur ek kiski hai? The rain. Which lines indicate this? Obviously, these lines indicate this. This line tells you the poet is talking, and this line tells you that the rain is talking. Fine, very simple questions. What does the phrase strange to tell mean? Strange to tell, ye iska kya matlab hai? This strange to tell refers to the surprise that the poet receives, or the shock that the poet feels when the rain answer backs, because a rain cannot talk to you. So the poet is really surprised when the rain answer backs. It is really strange. Rain does not speak. Rain is not a human. But because the rain has been personified, so it is talking, it is answering back, and this is a very strange phenomenon. तो स्ट्रेंज क्यों है, अजीब क्यों है, अलग क्यों है? क्योंकि रेन बात नहीं करती है, बट यहां इट इज आंसरिंग. देर इज अ पैरेलल ड्रॉन बिटवीन रेन एंड म्यूजिक. विच वर्ड्स इंडिकेट दिस? एक्सप्लेन द सिमिलैरिटी बिटवीन द टू. तो ये सारा एक्सप्लेनेशन जो यहां मैंने आपको दिया है बेटा, इट विल बी द आंसर. These are the lines that tell you about the similarity between rain and music. और वो similarity क्या है कि just as a song issues from the birthplace, that is the heart of the singer, rain also issues from its birthplace, that is earth. And after doing its job all over the world, like a song travels all over the world, the rain also falls all over the world. Wrecked or unwrecked, whether it is liked by people or not liked by people, whether the rain is appreciated by people or not appreciated by people, the rain and the song both duly with love return to their original places. And the original place for the song is the heart of the singer, and the origin for the rain is earth. This is what the answer will be. I will be sending you notes as well. How is the cyclic movement of the rain brought out in the poem? Compare it with what you have learnt in the sign. So you are making this water cycle in your fair copies. You will Google it and you will find it. I want a proper, beautifully drawn and coloured water cycle of rain. Okay? And in these lines here, the entire water cycle is explained. Evaporation, condensation, vaguely formed, and then I descend se kya ho gaya? Precipitation. In these lines it has been explained. Why are the last two lines put up within the brackets? I just told you why they have been put up, because these are the thoughts and observations of the poet. List the pair of opposites found in the poem. So there are many opposites in the poem. For example, here, wrecked, unwrecked, day and night, rise and descend. Ye opposites hain. So these are the opposites that have been used in the poetry. So my dear children, these exercises you will be doing, and of course I will be sending you some reference to context extracts also that will be put in your register. So you are doing these question answers, you will be doing the extract that I will send you, and you will also make this water cycle. You will take help from Google and make it nice and beautiful in your fair registers. Okay, so you will be receiving your extracts, you will be receiving a PPT, and you will be receiving the answers for the questions that I have given you here. Please go through it, make notes the way I have made it in the book, and in case if there is any problem, you know where to find me. Okay, so take care, utilize your day in understanding the poem and completing the work, and send the work to me, class 11th. I am not getting work from you children like I was getting earlier. So I want the work to come to me immediately when it is done. Else I will start calling your parents. So please get serious. Take English as a very important subject. Otherwise things will go bad. So on this note, I just hope that you will take up things properly. And complete your work duly and give it to me in time. Fine. Have a nice day. Take care.